Wow, I haven't been under bright lights in so long. This is, here are all my little kids. Oh, yeah.
Let's talk about Jesus, the King of Kings. Is He the Lord of Lords, supreme through all eternity? The great I Am, the way, the truth, the light, the door. Let's talk about Jesus more and more.
You know, I was watching a video about 4 weeks ago, and it was from 20 years ago, and I go, those kids are really talented. Wow. Samantha was coming from South Dakota. I said, let's do it again. So I always introduce my kids. Nathan, right in the back playing banjo. Lives with his wife and 4 kids in Juneau. Then we have Samantha. 4 kids. Please. Right? Another one coming? Lives in South Dakota with her husband Jason and Noah, where are you? Noah, he lives in Honolulu with his wife and 6 kids. Dana, she lives in the town of Rurika too with her husband and 5 kids, and you can see there's one in the oven there too. That's really good. Dana, let's see. I always do this. Nate, Sam, Noah, Dana, Livia. Livia lives in Jackson with her husband. He has 1 child with her husband and 1 on the way too. We have 22 grandkids and 2 on the way. It is exciting, yeah. Amanda, where are you? She's on the base in the back. She's working hard on the farm, on the store, and she just keeps things moving at home. That's great. And Amanda Lincoln, right here's Lincoln. Also living with his 2 children in Tonto Rico with his wife. And Jed is out there right there in back by Amanda. He went and asked the girl to marry him today. She got the birthday later. We're really happy about that. Lexi, where's Lexi? Lexi. Now, when things don't get done on the farm, she makes sure it does. She is just into all that particular stuff to keep us moving. So we are just so pleased to have this as a family. And it is fun to be here for a kind of a reunion thing. Christ, I don't know why we'd want to live in this place, because we have a reason to wake up in the morning. Next song is called Love Lifted Me. The love of God is what lifts us up and keeps us going every day. How's that banjo finger doing, Nate? You know, it's been 15 years since he played that thing. We're trying to count the songs up super fast and getting really nervous.
Master of the sea.
can see it all. For the Father lies over the way to prepare us a dwelling place there.
In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore.
Nathan's going to sing Three Rusty Nails, and you know, this world doesn't like to talk about the cross of Jesus Christ much. It's unfortunate because that's what life revolves around here, one way or another. We have to make a decision about what happened on that cross, and three rusty nails nailed someone there that did not deserve that death. And I've raised my family with that truth. They love it, and they are leaders, I say, to keep on sharing that truth in the place where they're planted. And that's what we have to do as fathers. We have to have that love for our children to really instill the important things in their hearts so they can share with their families and take it out further. It's up to all of us. So here's Three Rusty Nails.
Take our fades away. With three rusty nails in an old oak tree, the sacrifice was made for you and me. We were afraid to say that he was the one. What have we done?
I guess the question is, have we all seen the light? This is a world filled with darkness. We have deception all around, and Satan is so good. He takes truth and masquerades it as truth when he messes it up with some darkness too. The cross of Christ alone saves us, but yet how many places can you go and see a taught the cross plus something? The cross plus this, the cross plus that will save you. When it's the cross alone, according to the Word of God. So we need people to see the light. That's our next song here. We always enjoy this one. I saw the light. We only put this song in the set list so we could hear Dana playing harmonica. And she's still got it. During practices. We want to hear you do it again.
We need a guitar lick. The guitar lick comes in. All right.
She will have a harmonica verse in there.
We want to hear that.
She's supposed to introduce us here. Don't try it at home. There are loved ones up in glory whose dear faces we often face. When you close your earthly story, will you join them in their bliss? Will a circle be unbroken by light? That's what we're living for, I tell you. That's what we're all living for.
Wow.
But until we get there, we can have a little fun down here too with sharing the gospel. The Lighthouse is one of our favorite songs, and I used to always do that one. But I haven't been singing for a day or two, and that high note just got higher for some reason. I think it still sounded okay. What do you guys think? By the way, I want to introduce to you the most. Most precious person in the whole wide world. My house.
There's a lighthouse on the hillside that overlooks life's sea.
Full of hope, so full of the future. It's something you should want to share with everybody. It gets sweeter every day as the days go by. And so next song here, Samantha, Dana.
My name is Olivia.
Olivia. I really missed hearing those three fiddles together.
Oh, isn't it wonderful?
Man, they used to play that fiddle a lot too, and we had four once, didn't we?
Yeah, we did.
She won't admit to it, but she did.
Yes, she did.
Anyhow, sweeter as the days go by.
The more I love him, the more I trust him. Nothing good for me he'll deny. The longer I know him, the better I can show him. I couldn't stop now if I tried. Oh, he's sweeter go by. It gets sweeter as the moments fly. Your love is richer, deeper, fuller, sweeter, 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 sweeter as the days go by.
What are you supposed to sing?
The moment he saved me, his goodness he gave me. He placed the love of Eve in my heart. It's great joy to know him, with him I'm going, and never more from him till we part. Oh, it's sweeter as the days go by. It gets sweeter as the moments fly. Your love is richer, deeper.
No reason to get depressed in life. I don't care what happens to you, because God is in control and you can use everything, and you can let Him use everything that happens to you for His honor and glory. There's always hope and there's always a bright future. Blessed assurance. We can believe that because God promises us that. And that's where blessed assurance comes from. It's an old hymn. Years ago we did a lot of old hymns. That's where everybody learned them. And they're even older yet now, but the words are so true yet. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory. My Savior,
Shadow of death. And when I was a little squirt, that was told to me that that was when you died. But you know what? That's not true. That's talking about your everyday life. It's called the low parts of your life, you know? That's walking through the valley of shadow of death, and it says God will be there with you and for you and walk there with you to get you through. This song is called Footprints. Many of you maybe have heard it, but another one of our favorites that Samantha's going to sing. Oh God, no, he does just that. Thank you. You and when you got home at night, you didn't even have a light switch to turn on. So, hey, let's play some music. And usually, mom got on the piano and dad got on the what's that sweet box called? Sweet box. Accordion. Yeah, that's what it is. How many of you out there played the accordion in your day? Ah, there is some out there. Yeah. But that's what happened, and the family all sat around, and you had a great time singing together, and nobody sings together anymore. And then when you have a family that sings together, they say, wow, look at that. I wish it for everybody, because it's just, it's great. So, I don't know why I started talking about that.
This song you may have heard before, it's a song that was done years ago. It's called You Got to Stand for Something, or You'll Fall for Anything. You ever heard that one before? It's been around a while. It's got a great message. You know, I look at my dad over there, and I think, yeah, where you at? I would say it'd be accurate to say that through the years, he has stood for things that other people maybe didn't agree with at times. But at the end of the day, he stood for things that he believed were right. And every person, not just in America, but in the world, it's your responsibility to do the same, regardless of maybe what the ramifications of that will be. So, that's all I'm going to say about that.
I have found a lot more people to pray for now, too.
So we're just going to say, we know our dad, you guys know our dad, you're probably here because you saw us years ago. It's really special to be up here with everybody, and we're doing this song on purpose because I think it's apropos for what's going on here. And I hope you're all inspired to just know that sometimes it takes one person to stand for something, and there's a lot more people that are watching, and they're emboldened to do the same. And inside, we're all maybe thinking the same thing, but we're afraid to do that until we see someone else. So I want to commend my dad for that, because through the years, he's done that a lot of times. Even times when we were little, we were like, what is he doing? We're all good. That's good to go.
We still are.
Daddy didn't like troubles, but if it came along, every woman knew him, knew what side that he'd be on. He never was a hero, and avoided shining lights, but you could always find him standing up for what he thought was right. He said, you've got to stand for something, or you'll fall for anything. You've got to be your own man. you do today? You had to sleep into your night. Did you got to stand for something, or you'll fall for anything? You got to be your own man, not a puppet on a string. Never compromise what's right, and uphold your family name. You got to stand for something, or you'll fall for anything.
Other throwing a cowboy hats around.
I was breaking it up.
You know what was the worst time? They were both standing there and Jed's mic wouldn't stay up. And he put it up and it would fall down. And everybody started laughing out in the group and I was trying to be serious. I didn't know what was going on there. And he put it up again. Flip, down it would go. And the whole place was almost rolling on the floor. When I found out what it was, they go, "Hey Jed, nice job." But it was fun with the little kids there. It really was. It really was.
Yeah, there's lots of memories that are coming back with these songs, I tell you. A lot of the same voices, just older. And I remember them all, practicing in the parlor, and sometimes the cows would let them know if they liked it or if they didn't like it. Yeah, it's wonderful to be together. There's two people that are not here that usually are here for when we used to do concerts, and both my grandpas, they're in heaven. And this song, it's a beautiful hymn, and this is kind of in honor of them, so hope you enjoy it.
Until my throne.
is a wondrous attraction to me. For the dear Lamb of God left his glory above to bear it on dark Calvary. Cross, I shall ever be true. It's shame and reproach I gladly bear. Then he'll call me someday to that home far away, where
told me, you know, Dad, I want to be able to sing better. And I said, go for it. He found someone online, helped him with his voice, and we'd go in the barn in the milking parlor, and you hear, all the time, you know? But
we were just talking about
to it.
We can tell what kid is coming close, I mean, what young man or young woman is coming. And we always can tell when Lincoln's coming because we hear singing first, and humming, and then the door opens, and then who's there?
It's a blast.
It's a beautiful thing.
And in the parlor, you get the, what do you call it, vibrato automatically. It's just pounding all over.
Resonation.
Reverb. Oh, reverb. I think the milk production has been up since you started.
That's the next song we're
doing. Yeah, let's get out of the show here. Well, we have to take one day at a time. I think that's a big enough bite to chew on. One day at a time.
I'm only human. I'm just a man. Lord, help me believe in all I can be, in all that I am. Show me the stairway that I have to climb. Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time.
Play something. Katie. Jen, did she take it yet?
Not yet.
We'll take care of that this visit. And they wouldn't let us hear what they were going to do, so we don't know what's going to happen here. This is Anna, Noah's wife. Ashley Lincoln's wife. Anna Lincoln's wife. Here is Justin with the guitar. That is Olivia's husband.
I'm Jason Fink.
Yeah. He came from South Dakota today when he spoke. Thank you for bringing him.
So, I'm the fellow that promoted Samantha to wife and mother.
Thank you.
But no, I'm from South Dakota. I've got a construction company, a little construction company. We're getting into the busy season, so I moved some stuff around to be here. And when some of the siblings found out that I was going to be here for sure, there was some requests. But I decided to say something anyway. it is, in all seriousness, it is a privilege to be a part of the Sigmund family. I really do feel like I have two fathers, my biological father and my outlaw father. In-law father. No, we're being serious now. I'm being serious. it reminds me of a music joke that I have. Why did the musician get arrested? Because he was in trouble.
Things here.
That's not my fault.
Now, we even have another treat. Oh, a lot of the grandkids want to sing a song for you. Come up on the stage. Couldn't convince all of them because some of them aren't used to getting in the lights. Hopefully that's okay. What was that, Jack? Someone must have hit a chord. Watch the chords. You might not want to. They're going to sing Jesus Loves Me, three verses, and they're going to do the signing with it. And sing the chorus with them one time.
Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so.
I would like to say a special thank you to Aunt Amanda, our wonderful teacher.
You know, you should look at that song a little closer. There's like 5, 6, 7 verses, and they are fantastic. We just know the chorus, but it's a good song. I call it an adult song, but the kids love it too. Here's a song called Jordan. You know, the Israelites had to pass across the Jordan River before they could enter the Promised Land, and in this song, it's likened to us passing from this world to heaven. Across the Jordan, what is going to await us there? That's been happening a lot lately. Nathan's going to sing this one for us.
I believe my steps are growing wearier each day. Still I've got a journey on my mind. The lures of this old world have ceased to make me want to stay. But my one regret is leaving you behind. If it proves to be His will that I am first to go, and somehow I have a feeling it comes your time to travel likewise, don't be lost, for I will be the first one that you see. Cause I'll be waiting on the far side banks of Jordan. I'll be waiting, drawing pictures in the sand. And when I see you come in, I will rise up with a shout and come running through the shallow waters, reaching for your hand. Through the years we've labored hard earn our meager fare. It's brought us trembling hands and failing eyes. So I'll just rest here on the shore and turn my eyes away until you come and we'll see paradise. But I'll be waiting on the far side banks of Jordan.
Surrender. You know, you have to live your life for the Lord. Once you become a Christian, I mean, then you don't have a life anymore, right? Isn't that what everybody thinks? It's like, your life is over, okay? You got to live for the Lord now. And when I was younger, it was sort of presented like, if you live for the Lord, well, then you got to go to some jungle somewhere and be a missionary, right? And that's not really something a little kid wants to do. I have had the message always, when you become a believer, you live your life for the Lord where you are planted, every day where you're planted. And that means, what's the greatest calling for a man? If he's getting married, your family. Bring them with you to the Lord and make them a family that's strong and stands for Christ while you're working in the factory or on the farm or in a mechanic's job or wherever you might work, at a computer desk. Bloom where you're planted. That is all the surrender is about. You're looking to glorify God. I surrender all.
Surrender.
best memories I have singing with everybody back in the day was hearing Dana Let It Rip.
Ow!
Pick on Dana?
No.
I just miss you, Dana.
That's
amazing. Things you find out when they grow up. I mean, I didn't know that was
I'm sure he was laughing. That's probably why.
Maybe. I don't know.
A little bit of heaven.
Lincoln, your older brother needs to consult about chords.
There it is. Sunday at first.
Sometimes twice.
In the morning and the afternoon, we went out and did a show in nursing homes. Because when kids are starting out, they really don't sound good at all. They can't get nothing done right that way. But everybody in nursing home loves it. And it was very encouraging, and we did that for the longest time. And then you get your first call to an official job. Whoa, boy. This is going to be fun because the next song is called God's Little People. And 20 years ago, Lincoln and Jen were actually God's Little People.
So we're going to turn them into little people for the first two verses, I think, or something like that. Have you ever seen this little skit kind of stunt thing? If you didn't, you're going to love it. Their hands are their feet. And someone's going to be from behind, reaching through, and they have no control over their arms.
The girls have been waiting for this for a long time.
Yeah, they've been waiting a long time. I have to say, Lincoln and Jen are good sports. They didn't want to do this, but I said, please. Samantha, move the stand over there.
Why do they look so
weird? Why are you guys laughing? What's going on? We saw this like 30 years ago and never forgot it.
You may wonder what the children do.
Their voices didn't change yet, see?
We may not look like we're worth a lot.
Sing it out! Into. So dads and moms, don't sleep on the job. It happens overnight, okay? So don't miss out a day of their life.
Big was kid with slain his hand, you know, Goliath was big, big man. He's David, I'll kill you with my sword. But David brought him down to size with that rock between his eyes, because he came in the name of the Lord. Was little just like me when he climbed up in the sycamore tree so he could see Jesus passing through. Oh, but he slid down so fast, they say there's still no bark on that tree today. Jesus said, I'm going home with you. Oh, I'd like to give my best to you. There's a lot of things that I can't do. You know that I'm not as tall and I'm not strong.
folks, small people everywhere. We got something for the world to hear. Lord, I'd like to sing you this song. And we're God's little people. We got light and we're gonna let it shine. And we're God's.
Well, here's a song called The Auctioneer. Now, there's a verse in 2 Corinthians that talks about when you become a believer, you are a new creation in Christ. All things are passed away, totally gone. New things are totally in their place. And we have some believers that try to fix the old man up to make him look good, but God took care of that for us in Christ. This piano's playing by itself now. All this newfangled technology. All she's done to that now. Okay. Now, unlike these young folks, they know everything really well. I have to have something up to catch me sometimes. Well, it was battered and scarred, and the auctioneer felt it was hardly worth his while to waste much time on the old violin, so he held it up with a smile. Sure ain't much, but it's all we got left. I guess we ought to sell it too. Who's got a bid on this old violin? Just one more and we'll be through.
$1, we'll make it two. Only $2, we'll make it three. $3 twice, now that's a good price. But who's got a bid for me? Raise up your hand, don't wait any longer. The auction's about to end. Who's got four? Just $1 more to bid on this old violin. Well, the air was hot and the people stood around as the sun was setting low. From the back of the crowd, a gray-haired man came forward and picked up the bowl. He wiped the dust from the old violin and he tightened up the strings. And he played a melody pure and sweet, as sweet as the angels sing. The auctioneer, with a voice that was quiet and low, he said, "What is my bid on this old violin?" And he held it up with a bow. $1, once and twice. Now that's a good price. But who's got a bid for me? The people cried out, what made it change? We don't understand. The auctioneer stopped and he said with a smile, the touch of the master's hand. Now just think about that song. That violin is what we are when we're born and live. But when the master touches us, he can play sweet music in our lives, and he's doing it for us. So anybody that you know that needs Christ is like that old violin. Make sure you take time to go over to that person and share the best news that you will ever see or hear in his life for eternity. Well, there's many a man with a life out of tune that's battered and scarred with sin. And he's auctioneered cheap to a thankless world, just like the old violin. Then the master comes and the foolish crowd, they never understand the worth of a soul and the change that's wrought just by a touch of the master's hand.
Give me 1,000, who make it two? Only 2,000, who make it three? 3,000 twice, now that's a good price. Who's got a bid for me?
The people cried out, what made the change? We don't understand. The auctioneer stopped, and he said with a smile, the touch of the master's hand. Years ago, we did an a cappella song called Someday When My Life's Work Is Over. And so, my last line is written.
Yeah.
I didn't sing it. But the oldest four started out singing that song, and then things happen in life, and all of a sudden the older four were starting to leave one by one, and I go, well, where's my band going, you know? So then the younger four took over. So we're going to have a little fun here. The oldest four are doing verse one, the younger four are doing verse two, and they're all coming together in verse three.
I think they're slightly jealous and a little intimidated. I'm not sure. You guys will have to really vote. At the end of the song, we're team one, they're team two.
Oh, no, we're team one, we're going first.
Oh, they are older. Okay, they'll be team one.
As it says, the first will be last, so.
we need our bass.
We need a note.
We need. It's eight,
Noah. Okay, no. I heard three different ones. This ought to be good.
Someday when my last line is written, someday when I've drawn my last breath, when my last words on earth have been spoken, and my lips are sealed in death, don't look on my cold form in pity. Just be the house I once lived in. My spirit by then will have fled. I'll have finished my time here allotted, but I won't be in darkness alone. I will have heard from heaven the summons to come. I won't be dead, but living.
If you have today yet and tomorrow, you can make a choice to make a life for God, make a matter in your life for people around you. So what is going to be written about our lives? We have a song called Will I See You Again Someday, for if you don't make a choice for Christ, you won't be with Christ. That's God's promise, I'm sorry, but it gives you time to make that decision, and then you can join your loved ones in heaven.
How many prayers were prayed, Lord, save at any cost? How many tears were shed, so your soul would not be lost? Time after time, you spoke to your heart, but each time you turned him away. Jesus knocked on your heart's door, did you let him in? When you cross the great divide, will you feel his love inside? Will I see you again someday?
Standing on the promises when they were part of our crew way back when. So we're going to have you do that song again, Jeb Lincoln. Don't ever be afraid to stand on the promises of God. They are always true. And you know what's crazy is 40 years ago when I was looking at the promises of God, they were true then, and I look at them now and they're still true. You can have confidence in what God says, standing on the promises. And by the way, there's someone else I'd like to recognize here. It's the person you don't know, you don't even know they're doing what they're doing because there haven't been a lot of sound issues tonight.
Amen.
Which is uncharacteristic of our shows back in the day. Like, there hasn't really been any feedback yet. I don't know what's going on. We've got our very good friend, Dan Marquardt, who some of you have seen, like, after our big family stopped singing all those years ago, because we just couldn't make it happen anymore, then after a few years, we missed it, some of our siblings, and we started again. And so we said, who's going to play banjo? No. And then, of course, Dan Marquardt was there, and he is an extraordinary drummer. Hey, Dan. He's sitting at the table back there. And we're grateful that he agreed to come up here because back when we were singing in the day, my dad had the soundboard up here during the shows. I don't know how he did it because he couldn't hear what you were hearing. The first few songs were always a little rough. They were sound check songs. We'd show up. I remember because what year was that? We played over 100 shows in 1 year. And farming. I don't know how we did it. Silver school bus, we ripped the seats out, we drove that thing around. Oh, that was a blast. Yeah. We had nights driving to all these little churches all over, like within a 2 hour radius because we had to be home to milk the cows. Do you remember standing on the wheel wells?
I do.
Yeah, I do. And they'd be waiting for bumps. They'd be starting to jump, you know, and that bus would hit a bump and up they'd go hit the ceiling.
Super legal, of course. Yeah.
We'd show up to some, you know, Wednesday night.
What are
church service or something? We're supposed to start at like 7 o'clock, and there's a dinner beforehand, right? We'd show up like our bus would drive in at about, I don't know, 6:45 maybe. I'm being conservative.
We got pretty good and at setting up.
I think part of the show was watching us set up. I believe it was. Anyway, Daniel, thank you for being on the soundboard. We appreciate it. By the grace of God, and now what do you do in life? You live your life for Christ. Well, that means your life is going to look like Christ, because He lives within you now, Christ in us, the hope of glory. So now we are going to love others with an unconditional love. But when you see even in the family members who can't get along with each other, and sometimes they're all believers, that hurts. And it shouldn't happen. But this song is called Why Can't We? Sort of listen for that message in here. He lies awake there all alone most every night, looking back on all of his mistakes, wishing through the tears that he could just go back. Cause there's a lot of things he liked to share. He just can't forgive himself. Even though God already did, if he can love someone, find the good within, in spite of what they've done, no matter where they've been, if he can let it go, set the debtor free. Romans 3:24, we are declared, and I have added some words to help you see and hear what the Word of God actually says here. We are declared 100% sinless as a gift by God's grace through the redemption which is in Christ Jesus. That is where salvation lies, in Christ Jesus alone. Not in anything we can do. I don't care how many times you go to church, everybody. God's not looking for that. He's looking for faith in Christ alone. So think about that. And that is liberating. That is freeing. You don't have to measure up because we measure up in Christ. Such a truth. This is Glory Bound Train, and we have a few fiddle players that are going to help us out on it.
Right. This is actually not Glory Bound Train.
What happened?
Dad, don't you know how to read the list?
Yes, but something's missing. You must not have seen the invisible song.
We're going to do a song for our mom and dad right now that they're not aware of.
Dan, shut the thing down right now.
Shut his mic off.
Dan, do not. We have all grown up in this family. Our family's not perfect. We've had rough times. We've had smooth times.
I didn't feel rough times.
We've lived some very interesting things through the years. And I think a lot of you know our family. And it's been really something. You know, when you're younger, you don't look at things the same as when you get a little older. I'm in my mid-30s now. And I'm married and I have children. And I'm starting to see life. I look back at how old I was when my dad was doing things that I'm doing now, and it's amazing when I realize our parents were doing the best they could with what they had. And maybe people didn't always agree with what we did. Our lifestyle was very different. We pulled a lot of things. We didn't have a TV. We homeschooled. We were farming.
We loved it. Every
minute. We did love it.
We'd live it all over again.
But you know, when you're kids, every once in a while, you're like, man, other people have these things or have these experiences. Mm-hmm. But now I know, like, without a doubt, I think they did the right thing. Amen. And we're so thankful for that. I know tonight is not about my mom and dad. It's about God. It's about Jesus Christ. However, they took God's word and they applied it in their life, raising us. And I'm just going to say that I'm proud to be your son. Thank you.
We couldn't practice the song even once because they were always around. So this is the first time we're going to even try singing it. So
you know what you're looking at right here?
Lincoln didn't even know about it till right now, so he's wondering what key it's in.
What you're looking at right here is a family that on their own free will wanted to work together to try to reflect what a family should be in today's world. And no, none of us were paid to be up here. I don't think so, right? We'll find out later. But this is the house that love built right here.
Early one morning, I tiptoed down the stairs to the kitchen. They didn't see me standing there with Daddy's arms around her and a smile on Mama's face. I knew what held them together. More than their memories. This is the house that love built. Every room is safe and warm. These are the walls that weathered every storm. Built on a strong foundation to keep our hearts secure. Turn around to find myself.
thought I had something smart to say about it. It was a piece of cake with y'all, that's all I'm gonna say. Now I know what I was gonna say. Fathers, if you love your children, the best thing you can do is love your wife. Okay?
Woo!
That's gonna be the key, okay? So, Lori Montrain. You have the whistle? You are a whistle queen. I'm waiting on the glory bound train. I'm waiting for the train to come in. And same engineer that is sending from here is returning for me again. Well, if you knew my Savior, you wouldn't be as a foolish man. You'd lay aside all your worldly pride, and for Jesus you'd make a stand. I'm waiting on that glory bound train. I'm waiting for the train to come in. That same engineer that is sending from here is returning for me again. Let Jesus save your soul, put your name on the roll, and be ready when the train rolls in. I'm waiting for the train. I'm waiting for the train to come in. That same engineer that is sending from here is returning for me again. They want to know if we can do one more. I'll fly away, they say. Nathan doesn't need practice.
I haven't did this one in 15 years.
It's the same six strings, so don't worry about
start
it.
I'll start going.
Now, I hope all of you are going to be flying away with us up here because we are trusting and praising our Savior. He's coming to get us all pretty soon, so let's get ready. Come back for me when this life is over. I'll fly away to a world that's way so sober. Another 20 years? All right. Thanks again for coming and have a safe trip home. Yeah. There's water in the back if you want it. It's been a long concert. I appreciate you sticking around. Yes. Have a good evening. Can we turn the house lights on? There we go.